After your journey, so I've made you a slap-up meal. Come on.
Oh, oh, wizard! I'm absolutely starving.
Hmm, me too. I vote we all go for a cold swim first. I feel pretty hot and sticky off that long train journey.
Oh, yes, let's. Come on, everybody pile in. Come on, Timmy.
I say, Jewel, that man looks foreign.
Yes, I expect his name's Gollywog.
Yes, or Tarzan.
I think we'd better call the police just as soon as we get back to Cairn Cottage.
Oh, I'm so happy. I just know these holes are going to be really first rate.
Rhubarb tart, my favourite, with lashings of cream.
You've had four helpings already, Dick.
Thanks, Anne. You really are a proper little housewife. Not like George. She still thinks she's a boy.
I think it's stupid being a girl. I wish I was a boy.
Really, George? It's about time you gave up thinking you're as good as a boy. I mean, Anne is just a girl, but she doesn't mind, do you, Anne?
Well, I absolutely do mind, actually.
Steady on, you two. The holes have only just started.
You seem so grown up, Julian.
Seize him, Sergeant.
Well, have you all enjoyed your supper?
Rather!
Right, then I expect you're ready for an early bed.
Oh. What was that mysterious phone call, Aunt Fanny?
That was your Uncle Quentin.
Yes, we haven't seen him yet. How strange.
Well, he is a famous scientist, you know, and he does a lot of top-secret work for the government.
Yes, I expect he's working on some new scientific discovery, isn't he?
Well, I didn't want to spoil your holiday, but I'm afraid, children, your uncle is being kidnapped again.
Oh, no! Bad show!
Crikey! That must be a bit of a blow for you, Aunt Fanny.
Yes, twice in 6 months.
Yes. Yes, sir. Still, I expect it'll all sort itself out.
Look here, Aunt Fanny, we were wondering. I mean, we don't want to be more trouble for you.
Go on, say it, Jew.
It's just that our bikes happen to be in first-class order, so we thought we could all go cycling for a few days. I've looked at the map, and there's rather an interesting ruined castle in Dorset we could look at.
Well, I'm always afraid that you're going to have another one of those hair-raising adventures again.
Oh, nothing like that'll happen this time, I promise. And anyway, Julian will always look after us, won't you, Jew?
Yes, well, you are rather mature, aren't you, Julian?
Mm. So, well, that's settled then.
All right, I agree.
Hooray!
It's a shame about Uncle Quentin.
I agree with you heartily, Dick.
Still, now we can go absolutely mad if we want to.
Yes, we can do anything. It's really first rate.
Say, this is a jolly wizard lunch, Anne. You really are going to make someone a great little wife one day.
Mm, my favourite, ham and turkey sandwiches, heaps of tomatoes, fresh lettuce and lashings of ginger beer.
This is just the kind of holiday I like. Picnicky meals and not too much adventure.
Ha! Well, don't speak too soon, old thing.
Your Fardo.
That's strange. Why on earth would somebody want to feed Timmy?
Yes, that was rather odd. Shh!
I say, look over there.
What a strange pair.
Yes, one's got a big nose and thick lips, and the other one's got mean, clever little eyes.
And they're unshaven. Just look at the way they're slouching.
Eh, poo. I hope they don't come anywhere near me. I feel as if I can smell them from here.
Shh! I can hear them talking.
What about the sparklers, Punchy?
Don't you worry about them. I look out of that.
Well, now that you're out of jail, you better lie low.
Do you think they're escaped convicts?
Yes, or traitors to our country.
We'd better call the police.
Look, Timmy's fallen over.
Oh, crikey! He's been poisoned!
Never mind, George, we'll get another. Come on, everybody, let's find a telephone.
Well done. Thanks to you, we've caught these two red-handed.
We're very glad to be of help, sir.
I must say, you seem very grown up. I shouldn't be surprised if you join the police force someday.
Thank you, sir.
You little bastard. I've just spent 15 years of my life behind bars. I'm going to kill you when I get out.
Phew!
Well, now, let's all stop in the next village and celebrate with some ice cream.
Rather!
I feel exactly like an ice cream.
Ah, according to the map, there's a shop there that does some jolly decent ones.
Mmm! This is grand!
Yes, I think we ought to pay a double price for these gorgeous ice creams.
No, no, young gent. I wouldn't hear of taking your money, but it's right down nice, I'll be bound.
I say, look at this, everybody. Two more famous scientists kidnapped.
Yes, there's been a lot of strange comings and goings in this village. Secrets and signs and threats.
Hello, Master Toby.
Give me some chocolate cake and some ginger beer, old woman.
You could say please.
I'm so filthy rich I don't have to. Here's a £5 note. Keep the change.
That's Toby Thurlow. His father's one of the richest men in the country.
Well, his son is certainly one of the rudest.
Yes, I agree with you heartily, George. Well, we must be going, thank you.
Yes, you really are a brick.
It's a pleasure. Right down nice you are. Here, take these sandwiches and cakes with you.
Mmm, I say. Thank you very, very much.
Yes. Come on, Timmy.
Hello there. My name's Toby Thurlow, you know.
Yes, we do know, actually.
I say, you four look as though you're having a pretty exciting time of it. I think I'll come cycling with you for a bit.
No, thanks. We don't talk to other children.
Now, look here, I own this village, so you better be nice to me. Look, just clear off or we'll call the police. I didn't mean to be rude. It's all because I'm an only child and I'm stinking rich and I've never had any friends. You all look so decent. Please, can I come with you?
No, we don't want you. Do we, Anne?
Well, I suppose he could stay with us for a short time, couldn't he?
What do you say, Dick?
Well, if he promises to be good, then I suppose it wouldn't hurt.
All right, then. But you must do exactly as we tell you.
Oh, I promise! I'll do anything just to be friends with you!
Looks like a grand spot for a picnic.
Rather! I'm starving!
Me too.
What's for tea, Anne? Ham and turkey sandwiches, bags of lettuce, hard-boiled eggs, heaps of tomatoes and lashings of ginger beer.
Hurrah! We're so greedy, aren't we?
You're pretty well developed for a 10-year-old.
I say, I think I found a really first-rate spot to pitch our tents for the night. It's right beside a lake and some woods.
Oh, wizard! We can all go for a refreshing early morning dip. After all, we're all used to cold baths every day.
Here, Fardo.
That's very strange. Do you think somebody's got it in for Timmy?
Yes, that was rather odd.
I know who that was. Who was that and how do you know who that was? Come on, tell us everything at once. We must know because there's something very peculiar going on. That's for sure.
His name's Dirty Dick. He was a bodyguard to my father, and a right ruffian, too. One day, he had a perfectly furious row with my father after he kicked one of the dogs down the well.
This is all getting very mysterious.
I think we're nearly there.
Gosh, we seem to be miles from anywhere.
Seems so isolated. I'm sure some pretty queer things go on around here.
Yes. Look over there. There's a man parachuting into the field.
So there is. Look.
Maybe it's a spy being dropped down into this desolate countryside. Or perhaps a deserter from the Air Force. That's even more likely.
Come on, let's find out.
Look. There's someone here to meet him. It must have been pre-arranged.
Are they burying the parachute?
No, it looks as if they're digging something up. Gosh, it looks like an atom bomb.
So it does.
Good work, Jake. Remember, don't spill the beans. You know what I mean.
Well, I've done the dirty one. How about me money?
You'll get the money, like I said. Just don't try and blackmail, and that's all. Don't worry about that, Rich. Top secret information's my game.
This is all getting stranger by the minute. What can it all mean?
Blurred if I know, but they're up to some funny business, I'll be bound. Come on, everybody, let's find the campsite before it gets dark.
Let's hope we don't come across any more queer happenings tonight. We've had quite enough for one day.
Well, I feel pretty hot and sticky after all that. Who's coming for a dip?
I will.
Now, look here. Isn't it time you were home?
Oh, no, thanks. I'm having too good a time here with all my new friends.
Well, I'm afraid there isn't very much room here for you. We've only got two tents. Where are you going to sleep?
I want to sleep with Dick.
But Julian always sleeps with Dick. Don't you, Ju?
Yes, it's time you scooted off now, Toby. You've had a long time with us.
Oh, I suppose Dick doesn't have any say in the matter.
Now, look here. We're the famous five, and that's how it's going to stay. Besides which, you don't fit in.
Maybe not with you, you dyke, but he wants me to stay.
That's a lie.
Ask him.
Do you, Dick? Well?
I don't know.
You thought you were going to get rid of me, didn't you? But I'm going to be your friend for just a bit longer.
How could you be so feeble, Dick? You know perfectly well he's going to ruin the halls.
It's not my fault, George. This whole situation's just getting too involved for my liking.
Look here, you've upset Dick now, you pesky little brat.
Can I do anything to help you?
No, thanks, Anne. You're a girl, I'd better handle this.
You really are extraordinarily grown up, Julian.
I know. What is it, Dick?
Nothing.
Look, don't let the girl see you like this.
I'm sorry, Jewish. I didn't mean to let you down back there. It's just growing up feelings and relationships, that's all.
I understand.
I mean, what's so wrong with somebody wanting to be our friend anyway?
There's nothing wrong with that. It's perfectly wizard. But what if everybody wanted to be our friend? Where would we be then,
I don't know.
Look, let's face it, Dick. We don't even know if he goes to a good school. Between you and me, he doesn't really look the adventure type.
Adventures? That's all we ever have. Always hearing secret conversations, digging up buried treasure, chasing people down tunnels. Why can't we do something else for a change?
Like what?
I don't know. Just building model aeroplanes or country dancing.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
Oh! Come on, George, you and I'll get some food for that lonely farmhouse.
Shut up, you little crybaby. You jolly well deserve that.
Give him a bandage, Anne. Come on, George.
I'm sorry about all this, Toby. I'm afraid it's all been a frightful mess. Julian didn't mean to hurt you. It's just that he takes our adventures very seriously. He's awfully sensible and grown up. You must admit he's got a wizard right hook.
My dad's gonna sue him.
Buck up, Toby. I think you're quite nice. Come on, let's do something exciting underwater.
Come on, Toby. Stop moaning. It's lovely and refreshing. Do the power of good.
I think this is it. Look, that car's got no motor tax.
Maybe it belongs to an illegal immigrant.
I shouldn't be surprised.
What a strange, desolate place.
Yeah?
Oh, good evening. We're the Famous Five, and we're camping down by the lake, and we need some food. We'd like some free-range eggs, your own home-baked bread, some of your own cured bacon, and your own honey, and some tomatoes from your garden would do splendidly.
Oh, yeah? What do you think this is, Harrods? Come on, piss off now, and don't speak to any coppers about me.
I don't think I really like the tone of your voice.
It's not the Rosses, I hope. Nah, just a couple of smarmy brats. Tell them to scour me. We've got some more dirty work to do.
Wait a minute. You must be Dirty Dick.
No, no. My name's not Dirty Dick. It's Dirty Douglas.
Look here, there's something very queer going on. What exactly are you doing in there?
Oh, so you've tumbled our game, have you?
What's that? Are we done with Dirty?
Sorry, Fingers. I'm afraid we're banked to rights this time.
Let's make a run for it, Dirty. You start the car while I grab the sparkles. We can still get away with it.
It's no good, Fingers. These kids are far too clever for us. We'll get 15 years each for this.
Oh, no. Not another stretching clink. I'm going to take the easy way out.
Ugh. What a horrid common voice he's got.
Oh, well, I suppose I'd better go down to the police station and get Nick then.
Oh, do wipe your feet, Dick. I've only just dusted there.
My word, Anne, you really are a proper little housewife. It must be awful being a girl and having to do all the work.
Well, yes, it would be nice to do some of the more exciting things that you boys do. Still, I don't mind being dominated. At least I'm quiet and pretty, not like poor George.
Yes, that's true. I say, is supper ready yet? I'm starving.
It will be in a minute, as soon as the others get here. Oh, here they are.
Hurrah!
Hello there.
Sorry we're late, you two. We had a spot of trouble, but we've managed to rustle up a hamper from the constable's wife.
Yes, she was a sweet old thing. She gave us some cold ham and turkey, heaps of tomatoes, hard-boiled eggs, bags of lettuce and lashings of ginger beer.
Oh, wizard! I say, where's young Toby got to?
He's been kidnapped.
Typical.
Serves him right for being nouveau riche.
Yes, and Jewish.
Come on, let's tuck in.
Oh, Timmy, you're so licky.
You shouldn't let him do that, George. It's not hygienic.
But we like it, don't we, Timmy?
Come on, girls, leave Timmy alone. Lights out, everybody. Night-night.
Night-night.
Night-night, Julian and Dick.
Night-night, George and Dan.
Right. Let's run through our evil plan once more, Mr. Knuckles.
What you are, Mr. Lennon.
Wake up, Joe. I can hear voices. I can't hear anything. Listen. There it is again.
Blah, blah, blah. Stolen planes. Blah, blah, blah. Missing scientists. Blah, blah, blah.
Shh.
Blah, blah, blah. Atom bomb. Blah, 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 Third World War. Blah, blah, blah.
Shh.
Blah, 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 kneecap ill. Blah, 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 top secret. Blah, 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 kidnapped boy. Blah, 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 everything ties up. Blah, blah, blah.
Shh. Missing scientists, kneecap ill. Do
do me a favour? Big secret. What do you think it all means?
I'm not sure, Dick, but it all sounds very queer.
Maybe it's some sort of clue.
My word, you're right. Come on, let's get some sleep now. I'm much too tired to solve this mystery tonight.
Me too.
Well, I can't see Kneecap Hill marked anywhere on this map. Are you sure that's what they said, Dick?
Of course I'm sure. Do you think I'm balmy or something?
Steady on, you two.
Wait a minute, everybody. Look at this.
What is it, Anne?
Well, it's only a hunch.
Well, go on, go on.
Look, there's a village here, Crutchley, and along here there's Thigh Woods.
Well, what about it?
Well, down here there's a village called Ankle on the Water. So maybe this hill here in the middle is Kneecap Hill.
Gosh, you're right, Anne.
Good show. That's pretty smart for a girl.
Luke.
Come on, everybody. Let's make our way to Kneecap Hill as quick as ever we can.
Come on, yes. Timmy.
Excuse me, Mr. Gypsy. Can you tell us the way to Kneecap Hill?
Ah. You folks don't want to go up there, do you?
Why is that?
It's just there's been a lot of strange comings and goings from the old ruin, that's all.
An old ruin? How exciting!
Oh, yes. No telephone, no electricity, no gas, no water laid on. Just secrets. And signs and threats.
Oh, I think I'm a bit frightened already.
You'll be all right, young missy, with your short skirt and your tight sweater. You know, you remind me of my naughty granddaughter.
Right, off we go.
What a horrible old gypsy.
Yes, he did smell rather unwashed.
Look, there it is.
Kneecap Hill.
How on earth are we going to get in? We'll never be able to climb over that high wall.
Perhaps there's a secret way in. There always has been in our previous adventures.
Yes, and I expect this will be no exception. Come on. Watch. Somebody's coming. Quickly, everybody, hide in there.
Blah, blah, Rio. Blah, blah, Janeiro. Blah, blah.
Shh.
Blah, blah, submarine. Blah, blah, leave it out. Blah, blah.
That's the same two men from last night.
Yes. They must have come out of a secret entrance in the wall down there. I wouldn't mind betting we discover it any second now.
I think I found it.
Hurrah!
I say, George, you're pretty spunky for a girl.
Oh, thanks, Dick.
Oh, blow, it won't open.
Well, perhaps the secret mechanism that opens it.
Of course. How silly of us not to have thought of that. I say, Dick, try bending that branch over there three times.
George, this must be their headquarters.
I wonder where this leads to.
I think we must be right inside the castle.
Look, a foreign cigarette end.
Yes, and it's still warm.
It must have been left here by some enemy of democracy, never expecting us to find it.
Yes.
You're quite right. We never thought you'd stumble upon our den of vice. Well, if it ain't them nosy kids, blah, blah, blah.
Yes, we are very nosy indeed, and a good job too by the look of things.
It looks just like them cheap phone things with a dead giveaway, Mr. Lennon, blah, blah, blah.
Look here, who's in charge of you ruffians? I demand we be taken to him at once.
Don't worry, you'll meet the boss soon enough, and then you won't be so cocky, young gent. Right, Mr. Knuckles, I'll go first, you follow behind, and if they give any trouble, boot 'em.
Righty-o, Mr. Lennon, blah, blah, blah.
We've been so worried about you.
Quiet, everybody. Listen, Toby, we haven't got much time, so tell us quickly all that's been happening since you mysteriously disappeared.
My word. You look as though you've had a pretty terrifying experience, old thing.
Well, it was a bit hair-raising at first, that's for sure, but now I quite enjoy it.
What the blazes do you mean by that, Toby?
Yes, spill the beans at once, because there's something very unnatural going on here, and that's for sure.
I think I can explain. Children?
Uncle Quentin!
Shall I wait outside, boss?
If you'd be so kind, Mr. Lennon. Thank you. Do sit down, children.
What's going on, Uncle Quentin?
Yes, we thought you'd been kidnapped.
That was all part of my plan.
What exactly do you mean, Uncle?
Well, now that you dreadful children have found out my little secret, I suppose I may as well spill the beans.
You mean the kidnap was all a hoax? Whatever for?
For many years now, your Aunt Fanny and I have not had a proper marital relationship. She's an unrelenting nymphomaniac, and I'm a screaming homosexual. It seemed pointless trying to explain it to you, you little prigs. So we concocted this story to save your aunt from any further embarrassment. Anyhow, it's too late now. Toby and I are fleeing the country tonight in a fishing boat.
But what about the stolen bomb and Dirty Dick and the two famous scientists and the poison meat?
That was all just a ruse to put you off the scent. They were all third-rate movie actors employed by me.
Well, you're wrong about one thing, Uncle Quentin. There is something we can still do, and that's call the police. Homosexuality is still against the law in this country, as well you know it.
I thought even you, Julian, might find a morsel of sympathy for your poor old uncle. For old time's sake.
It's no good, Uncle Quentin. You're a queer, and that's the end of it.
Hurrah! Hit the police!
Well done, famous five. We've had our eye on these two for quite some time now, and thanks to you, we've caught them red-handed. Well done, Timmy. It'll be a long time before they see the light of day again. It's youngsters like you we need in this country. I'm proud to have met you. Best of luck, Famous Five.
Well, that was an adventure and a half.
Yes, who would have thought that of Uncle Quentin?
I'm glad he's been safely locked up. I never liked him one bit anyway.
Well, I think after all that excitement, we deserve a slap-up meal, don't you?
Yes. Rather. I'm starving.
What a superb idea.
Cold ham, turkey, heaps of tomatoes, bags of lettuce, yes. Hard-boiled eggs, and lashings of ginger beer.
Hurrah!